It's a horrific accident that's rocked the United States and shut down a critical seaport. Now Baltimore is reeling in the wake of the fatal collision that saw its iconic bridge brought down.
The whole bridge just fell down. Everybody. The whole bridge just collapsed.
The moment tragedy struck Baltimore.
It still hasn't hit me. I was on that bridge last night at 6:30.
This is an unthinkable tragedy.
To hear the words that the Key Bridge has collapsed, it's shocking and heartbreaking.
Early yesterday morning, local time, an almost 300-metre-long cargo ship lost power and control, its crew issuing a mayday, alerting authorities to stop traffic just in time.
Hold on traffic on the Key Bridge. There's a ship approaching that just lost their steering.
These people are heroes. They saved lives last night.
90 seconds later, the ship collided with the Francis Scott Key Bridge, sending it crashing into the Patapsco River below.
Approximately 0140 hours this morning, our 911 center dispatched a call to the Baltimore City Fire Department for a report of a water rescue.
8 construction workers were on the bridge at the time of the collapse.
They began to receive numerous calls indicating multiple people in the water. We were able to remove 2 people from the water.
One miraculously unhurt, the other taken to hospital with serious injuries, while the search was on for the remaining 6.
There is not a single resource that we will hold off on deploying to make sure that this search and rescue operation is carried out to its fullest intent.
But after 16 hours, the search team confirmed the worst. The missing workers presumed to be dead.
Based on the length of time that we've gone in this search, the water temperature, that at this point, we do not believe that we're going to find any of these individuals still alive.
U.S. President Joe Biden has confirmed the FBI found no evidence of foul play and says the government will foot the bill to repair the bridge, which sees around 30,000 vehicles cross it each day.
I've directed my team to move heaven and earth to reopen the port and rebuild the bridge as soon as humanly possible.
But the impacts of this tragic accident will ripple through the nation for many years to come.
Our heart goes out to the families. This is I can't imagine how painful today has been. But they have got a whole country and a whole world who's praying for their peace.
Just the scariest thing to happen, right?
I mean, it's so simple. That's the thing about it. It's so simple.
Yeah, and I think about, like, you know, the Harbour Bridge, for example, has 250,000 people going across it every single day. And you think, could something like that happen here? Well, it actually has. Back in 1975, the Tasman Bridge was hit by a bulk carrier. 12 people die. You'll see cars dangling off the edge. But because of that tragedy that happened all those years ago, structural engineers now say that something like that probably won't ever happen again. There are lots of things in place, like pilot boats and tugboats that help guide these huge vessels under the bridge. And, it's... makes you worry, though.
Yeah, and at least in that case, the whole thing didn't come down. It was just that.
The footage is surreal of that bridge in Baltimore.
Yeah.